So you know that all the family members moved into the house of Canterville Chase, and it was a very grand trip. They traveled and they went into the house of Canterville Chase, and there they found Mrs. Mooney and Mrs. After entering the house, they went to have a tea, and Mrs. Otis could find what happened, blood stain on the floor. Mrs. Otis could find blood stain on the floor, and she was very scared. At that time, Mrs. Otis asked Mr. Mooney about the blood stain, and about the blood stain, she asked about the blood stain, and she pointed out that she did not care about the blood stain. She did not care about the blood stains in the room, and it must be removed at once. The woman, now what happened? The woman smiled and answered in the same low, mysterious voice. It is the blood of Lady Eleanor de Canterville, who was murdered on the very spot by her husband, Sir Simon de Canterville, in 1575. Sir Simon survived for 9 years and disappeared suddenly under very mysterious circumstances. His body has never been discovered, but his guilty spirit still haunts the chase. The blood stain cannot be removed. So one history of the Canterville Chase, she pointed out that it is the blood of whom? Lady Eleanor de Canterville, who was murdered on the same spot by her husband, Sir Simon de Canterville, in 1575. But after that, Sir Simon was alive for 9 years, and after that, what happened? He just left this place. He disappeared suddenly from this place after mysterious circumstances, and his body was never discovered. But his guilty spirit still haunts the chase. So the guilty spirit of Sir Simon was haunting the chase. The blood stain could not be removed. So the ghost of the Canterville Chase was none other than the guilty spirit of Sir Simon de Canterville. So the blood stain could not be removed. That was all nonsense, cried Washington Otis. So this is the part 3 starting, and Washington Otis pointed out that it was all nonsense, and he would use what? Pinkerton's Champion Stain Remover and Paragon Detergent would clean it up in no time. He pointed out that nothing required, only Pinkerton's Champion Stain Remover and Paragon Detergent will clean it in no time. And before the terrified housekeeper could inquire, means the terrified, the scared, and housekeeper was very afraid that how could the blood stain be clean? She could not stay anything, she could not stop anything. And she, young Miss Washington Otis had fallen up in her knees and was fast cleaning the floor with a small stick which was looked like a black cosmetic. In a few moments, no trace of blood stain could be seen. So he had cleaned the floor with that black stick and Pinkerton's Champion Stain Remover. Now he pointed out, I knew Pinkerton would do it, he exclaimed triumphantly. So he was really in a winning mood. He pointed out that the Pinkerton would do it. But no sooner had he said these words than a terrible flash of lightning lit up in the slumber room. So as soon as he finished talking this, what would happen? A flash of lightning was seen in the room, and a fearful peal and sound, cracking sound of the thunder could be heard. And they were all start to their feet, when they were extremely afraid. The storm raged fiercely all that night, but nothing of particular note occurred. The storm was moving fast at that night, but nothing particular occurred. The next morning, however, when they came down to breakfast, they found the terrible stain of blood once again on the floor. So next morning when they came down, they could find what? The terrible stain on the blood floor. Blood again on the floor. The day had been warm and sunny, and in the cool of the evening, the whole family went out to drive. The day was very warm and it was very sunny, very bright, and in the cool evening, everyone of the family went out for a drive. They did not return home till 9 o'clock, and when they had a light supper. So they did not return till 9 o'clock, and when they returned at 9 o'clock, they had supper. The conversation in no way turned upon ghosts. So when there were not even those primary conditions of receptive expectations which mentioned at all was made of supernatural, nor was Simon de Canterville alluded to in any way. So the primary condition, suppose anything supernatural would occur, before that some discussions would take place. So that type of discussions were also taking place, and they did not expect anything unnatural or supernatural occurrence would be going to happening, and means some strange occurrences would be there, which would be the strange, which would be the incidents, which would be occurring due to the presence of some supernatural elements. No mention what at all was made of supernatural, nor was Simon de Canterville alluded to anyway. So they did not relate, means they did not discuss anything about supernatural, and no one was discussing about Sir Simon de Canterville also. Now at 11 o'clock the family retired, and by 1:30 all the lights were out. So all the lights were out, the family retired. Sometime after, Mr. Otis was awakened by a curious noise in the corridor. So sometime after, Mr. Otis was awakened by a curious noise on the corridor outside the room. It sounded like a clank of metal and seemed to be coming very nearer every moment. So Mr. Otis could hear that the sound was coming nearer to every moment, and it seemed like a clank of metal was going on, and nearer every moment it was coming. He got up at once, struck a match and looked at the time. So he could see us in a confused noise of metals. So at that time he could see that it was coming nearer every moment. He got up and was struck the match and looked at the time. It was exactly what happened, 1 o'clock. He was quite calm, felt his pulse, which was not at all feverish. So he was quite calm, he calm, and he thought that he was might be in feverish, means he was might be having some problem or illness, but it was not like that. He could feel his pulse, everything was normal. The strange noise still continued, and with it he heard distinctly the sound of footsteps. The strange noise was continuing, and with it he could hear some the sound of footsteps. He put on his slippers, took a small oblong phial out of his dressing case and opened the door. Now he put on the slippers, he took out a small oblong shaped container from the dressing case and opened the door. Right in front of him he saw the wan moonlight, an old man of terrible aspect. So right in front of him, what he could see, that in the faded moonlight he could see that a terrible aspect, means a terrible figure of an old man, was standing. His eyes were as red as burning coals, long gray hair fell over his shoulders and matted coils. His garments, which were of antique cut, were soiled and ragged, and from his wrists and ankles hung heavy manacles and rusty chains. Now what happened? His eyes were as red as burning coals, and he had long gray hair which were like matted in coils. His garments were there of antique cut, means he was wearing very old garments, which were soiled and ragged, means ragged and patched, means very old thing, and they were colorless, very much spoiled garments he was wearing. And from his wrist and ankle, which were there, heavy iron chains were hanging, and rusty chains were there, means his feet, hands were all tied, or all were in the chains.